Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Ramesh Mudgal and welcome to my channel Mudgal's Musings, and I'm very happy to talk to you once again. If this is your first visit to my channel, consider subscribing. I'm going to be putting up one new video every week to help you increase your productivity. This is going to be my last video of the year 2018. It has been a marvelous year for me. I hope it's been the same for you as well. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about some of the ways in which we can put our smartphones to better use. I'm sure you're very, very smart people, very, very productive people. You're already using your smartphones. You're putting it to many, many fantastic uses. But I just have a few more things which I thought would be interesting to share with you. Okay, so here we go. Number one, whether you're using an iPhone or you're using an Android device, you definitely have an inbuilt app, which is, if it is an Android, it is Google Assistant, and if it is an iPhone, you will be having Siri. And both these AI tools can actually be put to fantastic use. They can do several of your tasks without you having to touch your smartphone. They can organize your calendar, they can organize your day, they can let you know how the weather is, they can let you know the schedules of airplanes or trains or buses, they can show you direction to the place where you want to go, and they can make a call for you, and probably they can even book an appointment for you in a saloon or with a doctor or wherever you want to go and have an appointment. So the point is, artificial intelligence assistants are fantastic, fabulous. They can do marvelous work for you. Do make use of them. I have started making use of them, and Google Assistant is becoming a really, really good assistant for me. The second app which all of us should be having on our smartphones is the cam scanner app. So it's available on all kinds of platforms. So we tend to take pictures of some important documents or some material that we want to be sending it to somebody else. Now, if you're just using your camera app and then you want to send that particular image just as it is, it may not come out very well, and the receiver may not be very happy with the quality of the product that he has received. Instead, click an image making use of this cam scanner app, which actually helps you make your documents, make your copies look more professional. They look as if you have used a proper scanner to scan your documents. So anytime, whether you're a teacher or you're any other professional, whenever you want to send some document, you don't have an access to a proper scanner, you can make use of a cam scanner, which is going to be very, very handy. The third thing that's going to be very useful for all of us would be the Cam Finder app. So please download the Cam Finder app. I'm sure it's available on all platforms. And then what you can do with that is that if you're walking around somewhere, you will find that something interesting. There could be an object, there could be an animal, there could be a type of flower, there could be a type of fruit. Now, at times it so happens that you don't know what it is, but you want to know about it, but you don't even know its name. So all you can do is just make use of this app and open this app, take a picture or a snapshot of that particular object, and then this Cam Finder app is actually going to give you the output, give you the results. It may not be 100% accurate all the time, but I'm sure it is going to serve your purpose. One of the greatest innovations in smartphone is the camera application. You know, ever since the cameras have been installed into smartphones, we know that every single moment has become a memorable one for us. We will keep on clicking images, we will take on video clips of several things that are happening around us, and why not? And in fact, the social media, ubiquitous social media itself, demands that we put a lot of photographs and images and videos. Well, that requires a lot of storage on your device. Now, at times you may run out of storage. So there are several apps, several providers who are able to provide you with a lot of cloud storage. I'm sure you may be already using it. In case you don't have the storage on your device, you don't have an SD card or a thing like that, so what you can do is that open up an account with probably OneDrive or Microsoft or Google or even iCloud. Google also gives you certain things, and Dropbox or several other online cloud storage providers are more than willing to provide you with a basic minimum kind of a 10 GB, 15 GB kind of storage, which I guess when you actually park your various files should be adequate enough. The fifth way in which we can put our smartphones to a better use, a productive use, is making use of the calendar app, making use of the organizer app, and making use of the reminders which are available on any kind of smartphone. Even the basic version has a reminder option available over there. With this reminder, obviously, you know, there are several things, important things that we give. Maybe you have to pay an electricity bill. Maybe you have to kind of call up somebody. Maybe you have to collect something for your child or your family or do something. Or probably you will have to you want to reply to somebody. Now, at times in the rush of our daily lives, we may forget something very important. So put a reminder for yourself saying that, okay, please remind. In fact, this reminder can be put making use of either Siri on iPhone or even Google Assistant on Android phones. So these reminders are going to actually come back to you and remind you, okay, boss, you got to do something over here. You got to call up somebody, you got to collect something. So the important fact is that you're not going to miss out on anything. The sixth way we can put our smartphones to better use is the QR scanner. So every smartphone must have a QR code scanner. You know, the world is actually changing fast, so you don't have to kind of write down everything, you don't have to kind of note down all the details. Even people are coming out with QR code embedded business cards, or in fact look at any product, it has got a QR code. So by having a QR code scanner on your phone, I'm sure you're already having it and you're using it. If that is the case, it's fantastic. If not, then it's high time that you downloaded the QR code scanner on your phone and scan and get all the details. If it is going to be a business card, just using the QR code, you scan the business card, the entire contact details of the person actually gets stored into your smartphone. How cool is that? Okay, internet is full of several resources, several articles, several tips, and lots of videos on how to make use of your smartphone. In fact, there are very, very advanced level of uses of smartphones as well. And I'm sure, you know, we're not going to restrict ourselves, our smartphone use only to check our emails, or probably to be on social media and respond to social media, things like that. I'm sure many of us are also using smartphones for doing our financial transactions and banking and so many other things. So we are already on the way, but knowing and making use of the virtual assistants is what is going to make your life much more easier. Let us, in the new year, try and make the most of your smartphone by making use of virtual assistants. That's all on this episode of Mudgal's Musings, and thank you for watching my video. And if you like my video, please do hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe so that you get notifications every time I post something new. And please do share in comments as to how and what fantastic ways you're making use of your smartphone. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful time ahead, and I wish you all a very, very happy new year 2019.